Yeah, hey guys. Welcome to another AMA. Today I have a question from Lanier816 from the ZTalk forum. And he wants to know, what's the purpose of a standby switch? He kind of asked that question on the forum. I kind of saw it and I thought, well, you know, let me embellish a little bit. As you guys might know, or maybe you don't, I did do a blog on the standby switch, and I did that blog March 10th, 2016. So there's a lot of information about what I think about the standby switch and its use in that blog. So there's no sense me going through that again, because you can just look it up and read it. It's only a few paragraphs. But basically, let me give you a little bit of history and some of the uses of the standby switch. Well, first, the standby switch was added initially by Leo Fender when Leo Fender was doing his initial amp designs. And, you know, Leo was a pretty frugal guy when it came to parts and cost. And he wouldn't have really added a feature like the standby switch if he didn't think that there was a need for it. And basically, Leo's feeling was, it's really a nice feature for servicing an amp, okay? And that was kind of why he put it in and left it in. You know, Leo's whole business and his whole beginnings were in the radio repair business. So he was a bench guy. He worked on a bench. He knew how to repair equipment. And he put a lot of stock in that. And the nice thing about having a standby switch is if you're working on an amp and you're trying to troubleshoot a problem and you have the amp on and it's a tube amp, you know, and you want to turn it off to work on something else or change a part or whatever, you know, you can engage the standby switch and in kill high voltage if you like, or if you just power down the amp and turn up the standby switch, it will allow the connection to the B plus voltage to your output transformer and kind of drain the caps. So you safely kind of remove the voltage from your caps prior to sticking your fingers inside the circuit. So, you know, Leo thought it was worthwhile to have that, and he did. And because of Leo's success, everybody copied him, you know, it's just the way it is. So if you go back to the earlier days, like Gibson and Ampeg, they really didn't use standby switches, you know. And if you also look at some of the high-end stereo equipment, like let's say you're looking at a $15,000 Macintosh tube amp setup, you're not going to find a standby switch on it. So it truly isn't needed in a circuit or an amp. And you're going to find very many amp builders and aficionados stating that fact. But personally, I still use it on my gear. And the reason being is it's relatively inexpensive. I mean, at the cost that I get high quality on-off switches, like a Carling, you know, 63 110 on-off switch, in the numbers that I buy them, they're pretty inexpensive. And it's like maybe a foot of wire, you know, 6 inches of wire in and out to really wire in a standby switch. And I find, you know, its purposes are many, actually. If you're going to swap a speaker, if it's a head cabinet and you want to swap a speaker, well, you toggle it into standby. You know, you kill that high voltage and change and swap the speaker cabinet. If you're going to switch to half power, as you know, quite a few of my amps have a really sophisticated half power switch and circuit. And it's always safe to kick off the high voltage, the standby, before you switch the power. The same with the Z-Rec and its comfort and speed control. Because there, again, you're affecting the power of what's going to the output tubes, either higher or lower. So you kick it into standby. As well as triode and pentode mode. You know, that's another thing, man. You know, kick it into standby. And then also, you know, its basic use or purpose is to mute your amp. So say you're going to go on a break, you kick it into standby, and you mute your amp. There are other ways to mute your amp without using standby. And, you know, basically you turn the volume off, turn it all the way counterclockwise, and then just, you know, pull your jack, guitar cord jack out of the amp a little bit. So now it's shorted. You got a shorted input and no volume. The amp is muted. So there are ways around an amp that doesn't have standby. There is a kind of a problem that can occur when you use standby, and that is the buildup of barium orthostate. Boy, that's a tough one. That kind of builds up between the cathode, the oxidized coating on the cathode, and the cathode itself. And that is caused by extended use of the tube being on, okay, the heater being active, but no high voltage being present inside the tube. So this barium will develop on the cathode, kind of mess up your tube's operation. But it takes many, many, many hours for that to happen. And I really have never seen this occur. I've just read about it. So, you know, I'm not even sure if it's something that we should be concerned with, but it certainly is something that does affect the standby switch. Again, you know, many builders will condemn the use of standby. I don't know. You know, I use it, and generally speaking, if you've got a solid-state rectified amp, yeah, it's pretty good to use your standby switch. The reason being is the inrush of current. You know, it's instantaneous with a solid-state rectifier. But with a tube rectifier, like the Gia has a 5Y3, you know, that's a directly heated tube. So it takes a while, you know, for the rectifier to heat up before it conducts high voltage, which gives the rest of your tubes enough time to be heated up and correct. And everything is balanced and comes on. So, you know, the low-powered amps, especially the ones using 5Y3 rectifiers, no, you know, you really don't need standby at all. And you'll see that most of them don't have standby. The 10, 12-watt amps that use 5Y3s. But, you know, some of the bigger rectified tubes, amps, you know, I guess it's a good idea to have it, but certainly on solid-state rectified amps, standby is a nice feature to have. And again, it is a feature. It's a feature that I use on my products, because I think that there are reasons for it that are useful and help an amp last a little bit longer and be a little safer for the user, end user. So I continue using them. So that's the purpose of standby. If you need to know a little bit more, like I say, there is my blog that I wrote in 2016. You might want to take a look at that. There's a little bit more information about standby switches there. So, okay, that's it for today, guys. Hope you have a nice rest of the week, and we'll see you next week, okay? One thing I want to add is, boy, I'm getting light on questions, okay? It's getting a little bit more difficult for me to kind of go through and almost even simulate questions from things I see on forums and questions that guys are asking. So, you know, if you think about it, help me out. Give me some good questions so I can continue to weekly run AMA. Okay? That's it. Thanks.